Morning students, how are you all? Today's value is respect your elders. So you have to obey and respect your elders. Okay? So in this class we are going to study a poem, My Shadow. The topic of the poem is My Shadow. So this poem was written by Robert Louis Stevenson. Okay? Robert Louis Stevenson. Okay. What will you do in the dark place? We will start to play by having a torchlight in our hand. Okay? So what will we do? We will try to make different kinds of shadow. What is in the shadow first of all? Shadow is nothing but it is a dark shape that is formed when an object blocks a source of light. Okay? Shadow means it is nothing but a dark shape that is formed when an object blocks a source of light. So look at this picture, children. Have you ever tried like this using your hand by making different images? So by using our hand, we can be able to make the image of a dog, the image of a rabbit. So many images we can able to do. Okay. So today in this poem, we are going to study about the shadow. In this poem, there is a small boy and he shares about his shadow. He shares about the funniest things about this shadow. Okay, shall we move on to the poem? See ya. I have a little shadow that goes in and out with me. And what can be the use of him is more than I can see. He is very, very like me from the heels up to the head. And I see him jump before me when I jump into my bed. Shall we read once again? I have a little shadow that goes in and out with me. And what can be the use of him is more than I can see. He is very, very like me from the heels up to the head. And I see him jump before me when I jump into my bed. So this figure of the poem is a small boy. Okay? So in the first line, the boy says that I have a little shadow. I have a little shadow. So the boy says, I have a shadow, but my shadow looks very little one. That goes in and out with me. So he also says, he wonders that his shadow is going in and out with him. And he also wonders what moves around him. And what can be the use of him is more than I can see. So the boy says that I can able to see my shadow, and he wants to figure out what is the use of this shadow and what can be the use of him. So he want to find out what is the use of his shadow. It's more than I can see. So I can able to see my shadow, but I want to find out what is the use of it. He is very, very like me from the heels up to the head. So the boy also says that the shadow looks exactly like me. The shadow looks exactly like me from the heels up to the head. He says that from heels. What does mean by heels? The back part of the human foot. Okay? The back part of the human foot. So that shadow looks exactly like him from the heels up to the head. Okay? And I see him jump before me when I jump into my bed. So at last the boy says, before I am going to the bed, before I am jumping into the bed, my shadow starts falling before me. And I see him jump before me when I jump into my bed. Okay, have you understood the first stanza? Shall we read once again? I have a little shadow that goes in and out with me. and what can be the use of him is more than I can see. So he wants to find out what was the use of this shadow. He is very very like me from the heels up to the head, and he also says that the shadow is looking exactly like him. And I see him jump before me when I jump into my bed. So he also says that before I jump into my bed, who falls before me? The shadow is falling before him. Okay. So the marble is heels, the back part of the human foot. Okay. Can you able to find any rhyming words in the first answer, children? Shall we see? Okay. So see here. See me. Okay, see me. You already know what is rhyming words mean. So the words which ends with the same sound is known as the rhyming words. So in the first stanza, we can able to find some rhyming words. The first one is see man me. Okay. So the second one is head bed. Okay, see here, head bed. So repeat once again. See me head bed. Okay students, shall we move on to the second stanza? The funniest thing about him is the way he likes to grow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. For he sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian butterfly. And he sometimes gets so little that there's no or none of him at all. Shall we read once again? The funniest thing about him is the way he likes to grow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. For he sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian rubber ball. And he sometimes gets so little that there's none of him at all. So, who is the speaker of the poem? The speaker of the poem is the little boy. Okay, am I right? So, what does he say in the first line? He says, the funniest thing about him. Okay, here the him refers to the shadow. Okay, the boy says, it is very funny to look the shadow because it becomes big and suddenly it becomes very small. So he says it's very funny to see the shadow. The funniest thing about him is the way he likes to grow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. So the little boy is comparing this shadow to whom? To the proper children. Okay, if a child grows, it will take a long time for them to grow. Okay, am I right? Very good. But the little boy says that the shadow changes its length and the height very quickly. Okay, he says the shadow changes its length and the height very quickly, and it is not like a proper children because the proper children grows very slow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. For he sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian rubber ball. So what does he say? Sometimes shoots up taller. He says that sometimes my shadow becomes very taller. How? It becomes very taller like an Indian rubber ball. So he compares his shadow to the Indian rubber ball. What is meant by Indian rubber ball? Look at the meaning here. So Indian rubber ball means a ball that can bounce very high. So it's nothing but it is a ball. Okay. Look at here. What do you see in my hand? So I have a ball. What happens if I put it down? At once it start to bounce very high. Okay. Likewise, the little boy says that my shadow will become very taller like an Indian rubber ball. It becomes very huge. He sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian rubber ball. And he sometimes gets so little that there's none of him at all. So he also says that sometimes I will become tall and sometimes I will become very little like no one else. Have you understood this? Shall we read from first? The funniest thing about him is the way he likes to grow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. Here the poet is comparing the shadow to the proper children. For he sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian rubber ball. And he sometimes gets so little that there's none of him at all. Okay, have you understood the second stanza? Shall we read the hard word once again? Indian rubber ball. So the name of the Indian rubber ball is a ball that can bounce very high. A ball that can bounce very high. Okay, children, can you able to find any rhyming words in the second stanza? Very good. So the rhyming words are slow, grow. Repeat once again. Slow, grow. And the another one is ball, all. Okay, ball, all. Say once again. Slow, grow, ball, all. Have you understood the second stanza? Okay, students, hope you all understood the second stanza. Shall we move on to the third one? One morning, very early, before the sun, I was up. I rose and found the shining dew on every buttercup. But my lazy little shadow, like an arrant sleepy head, had stayed at home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. Shall we read it once again? One morning, very early, before the sun, I was up. I rose and found the shining dew on every buttercup. But my lazy little shadow, like an arrant sleepy head, had stayed at home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. Okay, tell me children, who is the speaker of the poem? Very good. The speaker of the poem is the little boy. Okay, so he says that one morning very early. So it was the time of morning and it was very earlier. Before the sun, I was up. So he says that before the sun rises, I was up. So I was up refers to the waking up. Okay, so he says I woke up before the sun rises. So very earlier, I woke up very earlier. I rose and found the shining dew on every buttercup. Okay, I rose. So here rose doesn't refers to the flower. Okay, it is the past tense of rise. So rose is the past tense of rising, waking up. Okay, I rose and found the shining dew. So what does the boy notice? The boy noticed the shining dew. What is meant by dew? Dew means the water drops that is formed on the plants and the leaves during the night time. Okay, so it is the drop of water that is formed on the plants and leaves during the night time. So the little boy is noticing the shining dew. Where? On every buttercup. So the buttercup means a yellow flower. Okay, the meaning of buttercup means a yellow flower. So the boy notices shining dew on the buttercup. I rose and found the shining dew on every buttercup. But my lazy little shadow, like an arrant sleepy head. So he says that his shadow is very lazy. He is very active. So that he woke up earlier in the morning. But his shadow is very lazy. Like an arrant sleepy head. So what is the meaning of arrant? Look at here. Arrant means bad. Okay, arrant means bad. Sleepy head. parents need to get me completely inattentive. Completely inattentive. So not paying attention. Okay, so this shadow is very lazy and bad and it's not paying attention. But my lazy little shadow, like an iron sleepy head, had stayed at home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. Okay? He stayed at home. So this shadow is staying in the home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. So it is at the back of me and my shadow is sleeping in my bed. Okay, have you understood this? One morning, very early, before the sun, I was up. I rose and found a shining dew on every butter cup. But my lazy little shadow, like an arrow sleepy head, had stayed at home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. Okay. Have you understood the last answer? Who wrote this poem, children? Robert Louis Stevenson. Shall we read the hard words once again? Buttercup, a yellow flower. Buttercup, a yellow flower. Arant, bat. Arant, bat. Arant, sleepy head. Arant, sleepy head. Completely inattentive. Completely inattentive. Rose, past tense of rise. Rose, past tense of rise. Okay. Can you able to identify the rhyming words in the last answer? Tell me. Very good. So the rhyming words are cup, up. Okay, repeat. Cup, up. And the another one is head, bed. Repeat. Head, bed. Hope you all understood this poem. Shall we read from first? I have a little shadow that goes in and out with me. And what can be the use of him is more than I can see. He is very, very like me from the heels up to the head. And I see him jump before me when I jump into the bed. The funniest thing about him is the way he likes to grow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. For he sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian rubber ball. And he sometimes gets so little that there's none of him at all. One morning, very early, before the sun, I was up. I rose and found the shining dew on every buttercup. But my lazy little shadow, like an arrant sleepy head, had stayed at home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. So the author of the poem is Robert Louis Stevenson. Okay, students, now let us see how to write a letter. Okay, so this is the format of writing a letter to your friends, family, relatives or your parents. Okay, so there are some steps given in the book. The first one is writer's address, date, greeting, introduction, body of the letter, ending, closing. Okay, so in page number 72, they have given a model letter for you. First one, they have written the writer's address. So the address is very important. So you have to mention the writer's address. So they have given Krishna Boys Hostel, Model Public School, Kolkata. So after to the writer's address, what you have to write? The date. Okay, you have to mention the date on when you are writing. So they have given 10th July 2000. So after the date, you have to write the greeting. Greeting means it's nothing but to whom you are writing for. So if you are writing to your mother, you have to mention as my dear mother. Or if you are writing to your friend, you have to mention your friend's name. Okay? So in this letter, they have mentioned my dear Ba. So after the greeting, you have to write the introduction. Okay? Introduction about the letter. This is my first letter after these summer vacations. We started our classes the day after we reached the hostel. I have settled in well. So they have written an introduction. So next to the introduction, you have to write the body of the letter. Okay, the content. Main content you have to write. We have a new teacher for clay modeling and pottery. She tells us how to make fruits and vegetables with clay. We then paint them. They look so real. So this is the content. This is the body of the letter. So after finishing the body of the letter, what you have to write? See here, ending. So you have started with the introduction, and after to the introduction, you have written the body of the letter, and at last you have to end the letter. Okay. So we have an inter-house poetry recitation coming up in August. I'm really excited about it. It is a long poem, but we learn it together with our teacher. It is nice to be back in school with my friends and teachers. I remember you and Baba a lot. Give my love to grandmother and father. So this is the ending. Okay. At last, you have to finish the letter, closing. Okay. So you have to write yours loving. Okay, you have to write about yours, your loving and your name. Okay, have you understood the format of writing a letter? Shall we see from first? First, you have to write the writer's address, next day, next greeting, and after that you have to write the introduction, and after the introduction you have to write the body of the letter, and after this you have to finish. Okay, you have to end the content, and at last you have to close the letter writing. Okay. Okay. Next, let us see the reading comprehension. How to write the reading comprehension. So in this also there are several steps given. So let us see one by one. Read the passage. So what you have to do, you have to read the given passage carefully. You should not skip those given sentences. You have to read them carefully. So next, try to understand. Try to understand. You have to understand the each and every word that is given in the passage. Next, read again. So what you have to do? You have to read twice. You have to read two times the given passage. Read the questions. So after understanding the given passage, what you have to do? You have to read the questions. So there will be given some questions below the passage. So you have to read the given questions carefully. Answer will be given in the passage. So what you have to do after reading the questions? You have to search the answers in the given passage. Have to discover the right answer. So after reading the questions, you have to find out the correct answer in the given passage. Have you understood this? Read the passage, try to understand, read again, read the questions, answer will be in the passage, have to discover the right answer. Okay, and this is for your home assignment. Write the synonyms, antonyms, rhyming words in your classwork note. Okay, write the synonyms, antonyms, rhyming words in your classwork note. Second one is complete the letter in page number 73. Complete the letter in page number 73. Hope you all enjoyed the class. See you in the next class, students. Thank you.